Welcome to NASCAR America Overtime on March 24th. IndyCar made its first trip to Circuit of the Americas, a state-of-the-art road course in Austin, Texas. And American rookie Colton Herta was looking to finish near the front, but thanks to a late caution that changed the race, Colton had an opportunity to take the win, and he wouldn't let it slip away. Pulled away in the final laps in just his third career start, became the youngest winner in IndyCar history at 18 years old. And after an off week, it's back to action at Barber Motorsports Park this weekend, one of the most beautiful natural terrain road courses in North America. As I said, Marty Snyder, AJ Allmendinger joining you here. Colton had a big birthday, by the way, in between the off week. He turned all of 19, AJ.
Still can't drink the champagne.
I know, he still can't drink the champagne. No. Maybe Joseph Newgarden will give him that champagne bottle once again in victory lane in the podium. So I want to know, can they continue the momentum? Because even though he was good at in testing at COTA, I think he was still a little bit of a surprise winner.
Yeah, and it's really your definition of what keep the momentum. To me, is he going to be a championship favorite? Yeah, I'd be shocked if he is.
Yeah.
And what he's done at 18 years old is already shocking, so you never know. But I still look at the Team Penske guys. You got the Chip Ganassi guys, the Andretti guys. So, but if going out there and having strong runs like that inside the top 10, sure, there's no reason that he can't. COTA was a place he just seemed to love right away when he got on the racetrack. But Barber is one of those racetracks that still, it's a fast racetrack. It's flowing somewhat like COTA. So there's no reason they can't go out there and still have another strong run.
All right, let's talk Team Penske. Joseph Newgarden, first and second in the first two races of 2019. And going for his third straight win at Barber. This is a tough racetrack. Yet Team Penske and Joseph Newgarden have always been strong here at Barber. Why has he been able to pull off these wins at this racetrack?
I mean, it's just a same thing. We're talking about Colton Herta loving COTA. Joseph Newgarden, he's always talked about this racetrack. He just really, really enjoys
it. A comfort factor.
It's the physically demanding part of that racetrack, and Joseph is a guy that is in great shape. All the IndyCar drivers really are, but he's really put a lot of work into the physical side of it. I remember doing my first Team Penske IndyCar race back in 2013 there. By the end of the race, I had blood on my elbows because I would literally lock my arms in the car going up through the S's.
It doesn't get enough credit for how physical that racetrack is.
It's so physical, so I think that goes into it. But it's just a racetrack he flows on. And last year's race had a lot of weather involved. And he just went out in the wet and absolutely dominated that race. So I don't see why he can't do it again.
You talk about Barber Motorsports Park. It's really a motorcycle track is what it is. Elevation changes abound on this racetrack. Why is it so physical, AJ? Take us for a lap.
Well, they cut the racetrack. They diamond cut the racetrack a couple years ago. The tire used to wear out a lot there. And then all of a sudden, when I got there, they didn't wear out that much anymore. So it's fast. As you go through this whole racetrack, it's flowing. But I talk about that 12-13 section. There's a quick left and an elevation back up right. And wherever you get the wheel turned for that right-hand portion of the corner, that's it. That's as far as you can get it. So if you don't get it turned enough, it comes flying off the edge of the racetrack. And it's just a racetrack that it's high commitment. You got to challenge yourself that, you know what, I don't think I can flow that type of speed in, but I have to do it and just sometimes pray and hope that it sticks.
The guy who always seems to be able to make that happen is Will Power. He's 2-for-2 in poles in 2019, but no wins. And I know there's been some frustration with strategy calls. How do they turn that clear raw speed into wins, AJ?
Yeah, I mean, that's a tough question because Will Power, there's no doubt about it. There's nobody on the racetrack that can qualify and really sometimes has the outright speed as Will Power. So some interesting pit calls. Yeah, I know Roger sometimes sees something happening. What happened at St. Pete, they thought a caution was going to come out, try to get in there. Well, the opposite thing happened at COTA. They thought that there was going to be no caution. All of a sudden, a wreck happens, and the caution comes out and hurts the race, then obviously had a problem with the mechanical failure after that. So he's going to be up front. They're going to find a way to win.
Well, make sure you check us out all weekend long. NBC Sports Gold for all the practice sessions. And there you see it on NBCSN, qualifying 4 p.m. Saturday. And the race, 4 p.m. Sunday.